Probably just my dad, maybe, because he always was with me when I was shooting, when I was doing all my drills and everything. He always pushed me.
Mm-hmm. Is he still the one that pushes you now, or?
Yeah, he is, but more now I'm taking it off on my own. Mm-hmm. Now I'm doing more just my stuff by myself, other than always having him there. I work out a couple hours every morning, afternoon, and then sometimes I go night on my own, so it's probably about 5 to 6 hours a night or a day. Yeah, I get up at like 5 something. Sometimes I jump rope before practice because we have early morning practices. Sometimes I don't, but it's a long time. Not the average player. They go out there every practice, do everything everybody does, but they don't put the extra in after practice and before practice. But sometimes you have a couple hard workers that do everything extra and they come out on top. Just my own one to make it. Live up to the hype everybody says and all like that. I just want to be able to say, I don't want to come back and be like, I didn't make it. I want to be one of those. Since I've been on the scene, since like after 8th grade, freshman year, it was a target's been put on my back, basically. And everybody knows who you are and everything, so whenever you play, they know who just to put on you, who to double team, and all that kind of stuff. It gets tough some games, but when I'm on, I'm on, and when I'm clicking, I'm clicking. Probably it was at Kingwood after my 9th grade year, we made it to the championship, and I had 49 on a couple of high profile players that play for Duncanville right now.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. My state championship, obviously, and getting the MVP of the tournament, that was a big thing for me. You just gotta keep working hard. There's no real reason or way to top it unless you get player of the year, unless you get all the accolades and all your team gets all the accolades. But just getting player of the year, winning another state championship, and coming back and doing it again, repeats. Yep, it was like the highest of the high, winning everything, knowing it was all over and we came out on top. Only one team in the end wins. And everybody else ends on a loss, and we ended on a win. Probably Derrick Rose. Playing with him, playing against him. He's a freakish athlete. Right now, I'm just starting to just tailor my game after people, just trying to do different things with everything. So I'm just experimenting right now. Playing with him, it made the game so much easier because he had like eyes everywhere. He knew where to pass, when to shoot, and everything. But I never got to play against him, thankfully. But playing with him, it was nice. It was a good experience to play with him, see how he played. Don't take charges in games if you don't know if they can jump or not. Because I had no clue Willie Wood could jump at all. And then after he dunked it, it was like a week or two later, somebody showed me on the internet that he worked out with Corey Brewer, the dude from Florida that had bounce. So I was like, all right, I don't feel that bad now that he dunked on me because he worked with like an NBA player now. So I was like, it's all right. But I took a charge under the goal. That was my first mistake.